Welcome back to this video. This is my 12th video related with the forfeiture of share. Once again, this is Dr. Prince Francis, Assistant Professor of Commerce, MES Asmavi College, P. Vembello, Kerala. Today, let's discuss annulment of forfeiture. That means after cancelling the shares, what the company do with that forfeituring shares. There are two options. First one is withdraw the cancellation of the forfeiture and issue a fresh call to the defaulting shareholder. This is the first option. Second option is reissue the forfeited shares to some other persons. These are the two options. First option is withdrawing the cancellation of the shares. Withdrawing or annulment of the forfeiture and issue the same to the existing or defaulting shareholders, or fresh reissue to the other some persons. These are the two mode of methods after forfeiting the shares. The company may be either withdraw or reissue to the persons. Then let's see what is the meaning of annulment of forfeiture. Let me draw here annulment of forfeiture. That means cancellation of forfeiture. Cancellation of forfeiture. That is only on the basis of the request from the shareholder, based on the request from defaulting shareholder. Then it need to pass a resolution in the board meeting before the reissue or before the issue of the fresh call to the defaulting shareholder. So summary, in we can say annulment of forfeiture means cancellation of forfeiture. Then next is steps in annulment of forfeiture. What are the steps or activities related with the annulment of forfeiture? Step one is receiving the request from the forfeited shareholders. For what? Receiving request from the forfeited shareholders to cancel the forfeiture. Then based on the request, it is needed to make a board meeting. Conduct a board meeting to settle the terms and conditions of annulment by passing resolution. Then third step is sending a letter to the shareholder informing or containing all the conditions of the board to enter their name in the register of members. So, sending a letter of the board containing the terms and conditions of the board sending letter of the board containing the terms and conditions of annulment, and also to enter the name in the register of members. Then fourth point is receiving money of the due amounts, that means unpaid amount along with interest. Some penalties also should be given to the existing or defaulting shareholder. So the unpaid amount with interest amount, the defaulting shareholder should be given to the company. This is the fourth step. Then fifth step is restoring the name in the register of members. Then sixth, after paying full money, then sixth point is issuing fresh share certificates to the shareholders if there is any physical form. These are the steps related with the steps involved in annulment of forfeiture. First of all, receiving request from the forfeited shareholder to cancel the forfeiture of the shares. Then second one is conduct one board meeting to settle the terms of the annulment by passing resolution. Then third step, the resolution should be informed to the defaulting shareholder. That is the third step, and also should contain the terms and conditions how to enter the name again in the register of members. Then fourth point is receiving money of the due amount along with interest, the amount unpaid amount with the interest amount. Then fifth step is restoring the name in the register of members. Then last one is issuing fresh share certificates if there is any physical form. These are the steps included in the annulment of forfeiture. Thank you.